Dear friends, my heartiest greetings to all of you on the 75th Salgira of the independence of our democratic secular India. It's a matter of great joy that our country, the largest democracy in the world, has survived despite many serious threats from outside and inside. However, with the believers of Hindutva politics coming to power, our country is faced with one of the most critical challenges never faced, never witnessed in independent India's history. These rulers are bent upon polarizing the nation by declaring that only Hindus, that too who believe in the Hindutva politics, can claim to be the rightful children of India. Moreover, they miss no opportunity to denigrate Muslims and Christians, the largest majority, Muslims being the largest majority of the country, which is also the third largest Muslim population in the world. The saddest part is that those elements are questioning the right of Muslims to be Indians, who forget about being part of the democratic secular India, secular nation building, aggressively opposed its formation. They decried and backstabbed the all-inclusive freedom struggle as it did not agree to the establishment of a Hindu state, but a democratic secular polity. This gang openly sided with the British rulers for its belief in the two-nation theory, that every religion constitutes a separate nation. They killed even father of the nation, Gandhiji, for daring to stand for India, which would not discriminate on the basis of religion, caste, and gender. Dear friends, the Hindutva elements are able to spread hatred against Indian Muslims as we let the actual memories of the shared sacrifices and shared heritage become obscure. That I would try to explain before you. This loss of memory turned Muslims into a pathetic lot. We seem to be living in India on the rahmo karam of the Hindutva gang, as if we are at their mercy, and will we stay in India or survive in India? That depends on their good will. Anyway, I am grateful to IMC for reviving interest in the glorious heritage of the shared sacrifice of Muslims, Hindus, Sikhs, and followers of all other religions, which gave birth to a democratic secular India 75 years ago. My dear friends, I also want to stress on this fact that so far as contribution of Indian Muslims is in building India of our dreams is concerned, Muslims have consistently punched above their weight in numbers or their status in the society, contributing to the glorious story of shared sacrifices. We should never forget the number of Muslims, the population about before independence 21%, and after that 14% with the freedom struggle, they put in far beyond sacrifices in their number and their status in this society. There is not an inch of the land of India where Muslims with other fellow countrymen have not nurtured by their sweat only, but by blood. They nurtured Indian motherland, not by sweat only, but their blood. The Muslims were integral part of the building of the modern India from the beginning of the process, which got rolling with the 1857 War of Independence. Indian Muslims should be proud of this heritage and should not be defensive. Before I start my presentation, I would like to add two more things. That Muslims, when we talk of role of Muslims in the freedom struggle, we do not mean that only Muslims were participating in the freedom struggle. They were shoulder to shoulder with other country fellow men and women of all religions. They were fighting for a common cause. And the second is that they had no sectarian or separate project, but the project was an all-inclusive India to give birth to an all-inclusive India. My dear friends, I would take you to some of the slides, and this is the first one, that Mushtarka Kurbaniyo Ki Mushtarka Virasat Wala Hamara Mulk Bharat Hai, India, our nation of shared sacrifices and shared heritage. And of course, I would like to thank Humayun Sahab who, in fact, I had sent my slides with the text. He put in very impressive pictures and photos relating to these texts. Moreover, I also would like to share the fact that when I'll be bringing facts about 1857 and later different milestones of our freedom struggle, I'll be relying on the contemporary documents only. So, dear friends, the other thing is that when people say, when Hindutva criminals say that India belongs to only Hindus, they must know how India came into being in ancient times even. And I quote one of the greatest poets of India, Janab Raghupati Sahib Firaq Gorakhpuri Sahib. He wrote, Sar Zameen Hind Par Aqwaam Alam Ke Firaq Taafle Baste Gaye Hindustan Banta Gaya. I hope some friends will understand this Urdu poetry, but I'll also translate it. In this land that is India, groups from many nations of the world kept settling. That is how India kept emerging and assembling itself. I take you back to 1857, which started the process of the building of modern India. And, 70% armed Hindu sipais, Hindu soldiers, forced a Muslim king who was, whose rule was restricted within Lal Qila, Red Fort, forced him to take charge of as an independent ruler of India. And the song which they wrote for independent India, I think you must listen this in the original Urdu song, which was by Azimullah Khan Sahab. Hum hai iske malik Hindustan, hamara paak watan hai, qaum ka jannat se bhi pyara. Will friends be understanding this, or I read the translation? Sayyid Ali Sahab, what's your opinion? Shall I go ahead and do recitation?
आप ट्रांसलेशन भी पढ़ दीजिए.
हाँ, ट्रांसलेशन भी पढ़ दीजिएगा.
अच्छा, ट्रांसलेशन करना पड़ेगा.
अगर आप कर सकते हैं तो जी.
हाँ, but that will time consuming, right?
ठीक है, आप उर्दू में पढ़ दीजिएगा.
हम सिर्फ उर्दू में पढ़ते हैं. Most of the people understand.
ये हमारी मिल्कियत हिंदुस्तान हमारा, इसकी रूहानियत से रोशन है जग सारा. कितना कदीम कितना नईम सब दुनिया से नियारा. इट अपीयर्ड इन अ न्यूज़पेपर ऑफ दिल्ली 13 May 1857. कितना कदीम कितना नईम सब दुनिया से नियारा, करती है जरखेज जिसे गंगो जमन की धारा. ऊपर बर्फीला पर्वत पहरेदार हमारा, नीचे साहिल पर बसता सागर का नकारा. इसकी खाने उगल नहीं माइंस उगल नहीं सोना हीरा पारा, इसकी शान और शौकत का दुनिया में जयकारा. आया फिरंगी दूर से ऐसा मंत्र मारा, लूटा दोनों हाथों से प्यारा वतन हमारा. आज शहीदों ने तुमको अहले वतन ललकारा, तोड़ो गुलामी की जंजीरें बरसाओ अंगारा. हिंदू मुसलमान सिख हमारा भाई प्यारा प्यारा, ये है आजादी का झंडा इसे सलाम हमारा. अजीमुल्लाह खान साहब ने लिखा. एंड आई ऑल्सो वॉन्ट टू कॉल योर अटेंशन टू अ फैक्ट दैट व्हेन ब्रिटिशर्स हैड बिसीज्ड दिल्ली एंड रेवोल्यूशनरीज हैड डिक्लेयर्ड इंडिपेंडेंस ऑफ दिल्ली एज कैपिटल ऑफ इंडिपेंडेंट इंडिया, you know what was happening, what was the level of unity between Hindus and Muslims, you could understand by an anecdote that a new artillery gun, big new artillery gun was to be introduced on the morcha, on the front. So what was done, and that was not done, but that only artillery gun only. What was done, that Maulvis were invited, Hindu priests were invited, Hindu priests performed aarti and Maulanas recited Quran Sharif. So that kind of, and Bahadur Shah was present there. And the defense council, which consisted nine members of defense council unit, so four were Muslims and five were Hindus, they all were present there. And that kind of unity, my dear friends. And today Ayodhya remains a very big friction point between Hindus and Muslims. And I tell you, again, relying on the contemporary documents, how Hindus and Muslims together laid down their lives there. Maulana Amir Ali was a renowned Islamic scholar, and Baba Ramcharan Das was head of the famous Hanumangadi which is even today even is there. And they both organized an army of Hindus and Muslims, and they won many many battles, but due to the treachery of local Hindu and Muslim Nabab and Raja, especially Raja of Amethi, they were caught and they were hanged together at a tamarind tree, imli ke ped par. Unko kube tela, jo aaj bhi hai, aaj bhi Faizabad mein hai, us par unko phansi par latkaya gaya. They were hanged. And another, these were not the exceptions. And another two friends, Achan Khan and Shambhu Prasad Shukla. They were part of the Raja Devi Baksh Singh's army of Gonda. They also had liberated Faizabad and the surrounding areas. Due to the treachery of these Stooges, they were caught. And Britishers were so scared of the Hindu-Muslim unity, they, in order to terrorize, they skinned them. They skinned them and then hanged them on a tree. And did not let anybody remove their bodies. And another, the kind of great examples of Hindu-Muslim sacrifices, I would like to take you to Hansi, Haryana. It is in Haryana. There was a person, very renowned literary figure, mathematician Hukum Chand, and his friend Munir Beg. They organized the Revolutionary Army in the Haryana area, that is towards west of Delhi, and both were caught and hanged in Hansi on January 1858. But the most
Dr. Saab, we have a couple of minutes for you.
Acha, right, okay. So the most shocking thing was that Munir Beg was put on a pyre. Was put on a chita, and Hukum Chand Jainji was buried because they wanted to insult Islam, followers of Islam and followers of Hinduism. And another, I am just rushing. I did not know that I will have only 10 minutes. Anyway, I was told it would be 20 minutes long. But anyway, Jhansi, we know about the sacrifice of Rani Lakshmi Bai, but we do not know that his chief of artillery, Ghulam Ghaus Khan, and his cavalry were Khuda Bakhsh, and they had sacrificed their lives 1 month before the sacrifice of Rani Lakshmi Bai on April 4 at Jhansi Fort. And the day, that is 17 June, Battle of Kota Ki Sarai, where Rani was martyred, the Angrez officer who found the body of Rani Lakshmi Bai, he shared the fact that a Muslim lady who was her personal security officer, shadow, her, she was lying dead on the body of martyred Rani of Jhansi. Anyway, I am skipping Malwa, where Maulvi Fazlul Haq led army, saved a huge army which had been attacked by behind of Tatya Tope Rao Sahab, Prince Faro, Maulvi Fazlul Haq and Zahur Ali. They stood as a rock and allowed the army which had been attacked from behind to go, and they sacrificed. How many sacrificed? These were more than 450 army men led by Maulvi Fazlul Haq. And then Khan Bahadur Khan and Khushi Ram in Rohilkhand, that was liberated. And Khan Bahadur Khan and Pandit Khushi Ram, with 243 Hindus and Muslims, were hanged in Bareilly on February 24, 1860. And Khan Bahadur Khan, before being hanged, declared, "I was bound to accomplish this task of liberation of the motherland. It was a noble cause and I am proud of it." And then I think last one from me, Thana Bhavan is about 200 kilometers from Delhi. 14 Hindu, Muslim, Sikh women laid down their lives together. Asghari Begum, Asha Devi, Bakhtawari, Bhagwati Devi, Habiba, Indar Kaur, Jamila, Mam Kaur, Rahimi, Raj Kaur, Shobha Devi, Umda, Bhagwani, Bibi. And then Jallianwala Bagh, 381 martyrs, 202 Muslims, 63 Muslims. The whole land of India, the motherland is being aap usko seench rahe hain, usko kis se seench rahe hain, apne khoon se, chora chori, Chora Chori, February 4th, 1922. 18 people hang, 14 Hindus, 5 Muslims. Kakori martyrs, Ashfaqullah Ram Prasad Biswil, Rajinder Lahiri, Thakur Roshan Singh. Between 17th and 19th December 1927, they were hanged in four different jails. And then I also wanted that one of the greatest massacres, which very few know, because most of the martyrs were Muslims, Khudai Khidmatgars, 80% of them were shot dead on April 23, 1930. Udham Singh. You must never forget that before he was being hanged in London, he declared that his name was Muhammad Singh Azad. Yani Hindu-Muslim unity was being reflected in the sacrifice of Udham Singh, who says that my name is not Udham Singh, my name is Muhammad Singh Azad. We do not know this history. We do not know this heritage. And let me also finish with the thing that Inqilab Zindabad Dinara, long live revolution, was given by Maulana Hasrat Mohani Sahib. It was popularized by revolutionary Bhagat Singh and his band of revolutionaries. But the giver of this slogan was Maulana Hasrat Mohani. And Ajit Bhai, last one, Azad Hind Fauj, which was formed by Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose, second in command and third in command, but both Muslims, Lieutenant Colonel Zama Kiani and Lieutenant Colonel Ehsan Qadir. That is a fact. So rulers missed no opportunity to destroy this great heritage of shared sacrifices. On the eve of 75th independence of India, we must take pledge of remembering and upholding this glorious heritage and not let the RSS BJP rulers of India undo it. Mere pyare dosto, since most of you are Muslims, what I want to share with you, then don't be defensive. आपने आपकी जितनी आबादी है, आपका जितना नंबर है इतिहास में 1857 ऑनवर्ड, आपका जितना हैसियत है इंडियन सोसाइटी में, इंडियन नेशन में, उससे तीन गुना, उससे दुगना आपने इस देश को बनाने में अपना खून दिया है, अपना पसीना नहीं दिया है, खून दिया है. और आप डिस्पाइट दैट यू आर एट द लोवेस्ट पेडेस्टल्स ऑफ द प्रॉस्पेरिटी ऑफ द इंडियन नेशन. और जो हु पोज नो चैलेंज टू द हिंदूज, they are presented as the culprits and as terrorists. Come out of your inner chair. Please tell everybody, tell your family members, tell your friends, tell your children that you have contributed more than your weight in building this, and we will not let this go to the dogs. The criminals who did not spare even Gandhi, the criminals who did not spare M.M. Kalburgi, who did not spare Gauri Lankesh, who did not spare the great historian Pansare, Narendra Dabholkar. So we will not let this country die. And with Hindutva gang around, India does not need any foreign enemy. They will undo India, but we will not let, as the largest minority in league with the secular Hindus, secular Christians, secular Sikhs and Dalits, we will defeat them surely. Thank you.